What's up, everyone? Welcome to the Monday Night Wolfcast, episode 2 for April 18th. My name is Wolfie, aka The Werewolf, and today I'm joined by my friends, Zeromus3.
Yo.
And Sinist.
Hello.
Alright, guys, just get right into your week. What did you guys do for your week? And I'll start with you, Bert. What did you do this week?
Last Dark week. Souls 3.
Is that it?
Yeah.
No, I mean, like, there was something else you did, though, right? I know you did something.
Talking about Ludum Dare?
That's the one.
Just watched that and played Dark Souls 3.
Okay, question.
Go for it.
Did you beat it?
I did.
Okay, so you're on New Game Plus now?
I am.
Okay, that's...
I would talk about it more, but currently someone's playing through it.
And we'll talk about that later on in this part. But first, you, Scoots. What did you do this week? Or last week, sorry.
Alright, Dark Souls 3.
Something tells me that's going to be the answer
that.
For everybody. Oh.
But, I've also been playing Bravely Second.
Now, I'm an idiot, Scoots. I don't know what you're talking about. What is Bravely Second?
It's an RPG made by Square Enix.
Would this happen to be a follow-up to a game called Bravely First?
You mean Bravely Default.
That's
yes.
The one.
Pretty much a direct sequel. It continues after Bravely Default.
How are you enjoying it so far?
Pretty good. I got the collector's edition. Apparently, I'm the only one who got the collector's edition at my GameStop. They even told me.
What's all in it?
It comes with a soundtrack and a giant art book. And the collector's edition is overly massive.
Is the art book a hardback?
No. Unfortunately, it is not.
I do have a question for Scoots. The demo, is it worth playing through to get the extras, or is it not worth it?
It was worth it for me.
Do you remember what all it carried over?
It gives you 20 followers, I think, for
the moon base thing.
The whole moon base thing, and I don't remember the rest. I think it was a few items.
Sounds like the same as the first game.
But I never finished the demo.
Oh, did you not carry over anything?
It carried some of the stuff over, but if you fully complete, I think you get more stuff.
Got it.
Well, was there anything else in your week, Scoots?
Besides working?
There was one thing. We had a power outage.
Oh, yeah. That was amazing.
Wait, I thought it was just my street, but apparently, like, even Walmart went out.
Walmart lost their power, and it was quite amazing.
Yeah, because me and Bert were playing that night, and just out of the blue, he just cuts out for like an hour. So it wasn't just you then.
No, apparently it was most of the town.
Hey, Scoots, what happened? Did you guys have a backup thing at Walmart, like a backup generator? I'd imagine
we had enough power to like generate the backup lights and play music, but everyone got kicked out of Walmart.
Yeah, that happened to me once when I was at Walmart.
It was awesome.
Yeah, when the flooding happened because, like, the power went out, they had the little dim lights on, and then they were just like, everybody, you gotta get out. Okay, so I guess I'll go ahead and talk about my week. I have a little bit more to talk about. Besides work, obviously, I'm going to talk about a little bit about my experience with a little game called Fire Emblem Conquest. I'm not gonna go into spoilers for you, Bert, or you, Scoots.
Yep. Say whatever you want.
No, it's fine. But I'm late to the party on that game, but I've been slowly picking through it. I am playing through hard classic mode. This is my first Fire Emblem experience ever. I thought I'd go in hard and blind. I've had ups and downs in that game, but I'll start with the ups. The ups, I had an amazing chapter, which also made me extremely salty. I don't know if they have them in you guys' in Birthright, but there are sorcerer or whatever, magician type characters that, you know, they'll target someone on the field and they'll bring them to that spot next to them.
Yeah.
Okay, so I had one of those areas that was a, you know, beat the boss type map, and I stupidly decided to kind of, you know, pick off enemies one by one. Unfortunately, there were chests around that map that I didn't get a chance to open, and I stupidly moved one of my strongest units, and I mean, this unit is a fucking cold-blooded murderer. Like, if any enemy attacks this unit, they are dead. Just dead. So, lo and behold, the fucking magician's like, hey, check out that unit all by their self. I'm gonna go ahead and bring them over and trap them between me, the boss, and some fucking archer. Guess what? Biggest mistake of that thing's life. It was the worst thing that could have happened to them. But I also got really, really salty because I didn't get the chance to get the chest. Because my fucking strong unit was like, fuck all three of you, you're all dead. When it was their turn. I didn't want that to happen, but it happened.
And with Conquest, you can't redo maps, right? So you can't go back to get that chest?
Nope. Nope, it was over. It was quite the sight to behold, because not only when it happened, did the boss go for an attack, that attack the boss did missed. And to add insult to injury, the strongest unit I had fucking decided, nah, I'm not just going to kill them, I'm going to crit them. So...
Is your strongest unit, by chance, the general?
It is.
Okay, just checking.
Do you know who it is?
Yeah.
Yeah, that character is a monster. I've used that character. There's not been a battle I haven't used that character. Effie is her name.
So you finally done the promotions?
Yeah,
I got it. Holding out on for so long?
Yeah, dude, I waited forever to do it. I literally waited forever. I'm doing the Shining Force logic. I don't care what you say. Wait till they're at the highest possible level, then promote them. But yeah, she is a monster. Last thing I want to talk about that game. I got to chapter 20, and holy fuck, I have never, never had such a hard time in any strategy game ever. But that chapter, that is the worst chapter I've ever played in any strategy RPG. If you guys ever get to it, if you're doing hard mode, good fucking luck. Good luck.
There's that playthrough that you never finished. Of a little Shining Force game.
Yeah, Shining Force 3, Scenario 1. That battle, that one's also difficult, admittedly. But no. I'll just give a hint and say suffice to say that map has a wind gimmick, and it blows. And that was not a pun. That was actually just clever wordplay on my part, I guess. But yeah, I finally beat that chapter, and I'm enjoying it. Second thing about my week, Dark Souls 3, obviously. I started a playthrough. Doing with you, Bert. We have our parts coming up on at least this channel. Part 1's already up. I want to say I'll be doing at least 2 parts a week, depending on whether my internet decides it wants to cap early or not. We'll decide how many parts go up, but yeah, that's a playthrough that's going on right now.
Are you enjoying it?
Well, Bert...
Since we can only really talk about it through what you've seen.
As of now, better than Dark Souls 2.
Alright.
I could tell you grit your teeth when you said that. Does it bother you that I said that, Bert? No, better than Dark Souls 2?
You have opinions, and that's fine.
I do have opinions. It's so good. Dark Souls 3 is actually really fun. I'm enjoying it so far.
Do you miss anything from Bloodborne, like the dash, or are you okay with how it plays?
I kind of actually, playing Dark Souls 3 again after so long, or rather playing a Dark Souls game after so long, I did miss having a block button. It's kind of nice to be able to block attacks instead of having to, you know, just dodge.
Yeah.
Or parry. So, yeah, it's a pretty good step up. I'm okay with it. Oh, final thing about my week. I said last thing was the final thing, but freak it, this is the final thing. Today at work, I got to finally see Disney on Ice. I basically got paid to stand... near the entrance of the place where people enter, and I got to see Disney on Ice, all 4 hours of it. Best day of work I've had so far working at CenturyLink. Pretty awesome. That's it. Okay, so go ahead and move on to the gaming news. And we're gonna go ahead and start us off with the 3D version of Legend of Zelda. was playable on a browser, and this was about a week ago. Nintendo has since taken the game down.
And I never got a chance to see what this was. Did any of you play it?
No.
No, I just saw the headlines, and I was reading it, and I was like, huh, you know.
Yeah, I only really caught wind of it whenever Nintendo took it down.
It looked really cool, admittedly, and I'm not the biggest Zelda fan. In fact, I'm not a Zelda fan, but I like the way it looked. It looked like, what's that game?
Like 3D Dot Game
3D Dot Heroes, that's the one, right?
Also from Software Game.
Exactly. It looked pretty good. I would have actually probably just given it a shot just because I like the way it looked. But yeah, I mean, it's kind of a given at this point. Anything you make that's a Nintendo fan base game is gonna get taken down by Nintendo. It's just how it is. There's the breaks.
Do you know if it was the whole game?
I think it was. I'm not 100% sure. I mean, it was taken down literally like you. I saw it a day before, and the next day it was taken down. So, yeah, it might have been the full game.
Hmm. Oh, interesting.
And, yeah, it's a shame, really. What was the last game that Nintendo took down? Wasn't like I don't remember.
Remember they tried taking down some kind of like Pokemon themed party.
Oh yeah, I think that was because they were charging entry.
Yeah, they were charging entry.
Yeah, for the Pokemon party, and they were like, nah, you can't be doing that shit.
I don't think I've ever heard of anyone doing that.
I suppose it's because they're using their like IP.
It's understandable, but
yeah,
I thought that was funny.
It's like, I mean, it's complete opposite for like the FGC, but it's like, you know, someone coming in and being like, you can't.
Oh yeah, Nintendo. That's another one.
Oh yeah, they did that with Smash.
They tried to keep Smash out of Evo.
They did. Oh, and guess what? My favorite company did that too. Sega fucking took out Virtua Fighter 4 Evo from Evo. They didn't like that. So that's why there hasn't ever been a Virtua Fighter since. I think they loosened up with like 5 or Final Showdown. I can't remember which one was like a side event.
I wonder if Dengeki Bunko or whatever is going to be as a side tournament.
Dude, I think they said at the upcoming fighting tournament that they're going to have an anime side block. And I think Dengeki and what's the other? Persona, Ultimax, and like a couple other anime games are going to be there.
Has that Shining game come out on disc yet?
Yeah, PS, remember? Yeah, PS3 in Japan, but no online.
Oh, right. Right. Perfect for local tournaments, then.
Perfect. They optimized it for local tournament play.
Exactly.
Brilliant. I hate the new Shining games. I hate them. Including this fighting game.
It's a topic for another time.
I know. Okay. Speaking of a topic for another time, this is actually late again, but the PS4 3.50 update, Musashi, released. And you already know where I'm going with this, with the title alone.
That's not even... Don't worry about it.
Oh. So for those of you
don't want another Sashi after 2.
But Brave Prince Musashi is literally the perfect PS1 game. I just want a sequel to it. I don't count Samurai Legend. No, that's not a sequel. That's not a sequel.
You know, the funny thing is they'll probably release it on PS4 PlayStation 2 emulation.
That'd be great. I love that.
I want a trailer for it, and I want it to have, like, the Musashi music and have it, like, slowly playing over and have, like, the text coming up, be like, you guys have been asking for a long time, and finally the remaster you all wanted.
Is that going to be
Samurai Legend Musashi?
Is that going to be at Sony's E3 conference?
Yes, and when it happens, I will do a fucking reaction on it, and you will see my heart break.
And everyone else will be like, what is this?
We'll do a Kickstart.
What niche game is this?
Yeah, it's going to launch a Kickstarter, and no one's going to do it.
No one will do it. Unlike Shenmue 3, which everyone wanted for years, and we're getting.
They think they want it.
When it comes out,
they realize they don't want it.
Well, had it have been funded and like done by the AM2 branch, yeah. But this is going to be indie. So, yeah, it's going to be a hell of a downgrade. Just imagine what Shenmue could do with Virtua Fighter 5 Final Showdown, like... you know, the fighting engine of that game in Shenmue, when you bound people and shit.
Yeah, I want that to happen.
One frame knees, We can get into that. Man, we went completely off topic, but the update for PS4
Yeah,
basically.
we did.
Dude, Musashi will do that. But just. I'm sorry, I gotta say one more thing. Musashi, if you haven't played Brave Fencer Musashi, fucking play that game. It is so good. It is.
You should probably play the second game instead.
Don't even. It's. Okay.
Let me just go back on topic.
Yeah.
It took him this long to add an offline status feature.
Good for people like me who like to appear offline at all times.
Yep, makes you impossible to contact.
Yeah, antisocial.
But that's fine.
You only need to contact me when it's important.
It's okay, they added Fred online notifications, so now I can be notified when you come online.
If I don't have it set to set offline immediately. But what's even better than that is that we can now schedule gaming events so we can play together.
You hate schedules, though. You don't stick to them.
Except for this one, because this shit's going out Monday.
For now, you stick to it.
Keep tuning in, guys. I promise you, they're going to keep coming.
You may list all those features, but you didn't list the most important feature.
Oh,
the
my
remote
God.
Play with PC.
Have you tried that out, Scoots?
Nope.
Oh. All right, then.
The most important feature that I have yet to use. But it works with Windows 8.1, Windows 10 or later, and some other shit that no one else uses. So
trying to say no one uses a Mac? Oh, you said OS 10.
No one important uses
did you
a
say
Mac.
OS 10?
I didn't.
Or did
I
you say
said,
Windows 10?
That was other. I said Windows 10.
Okay.
Don't worry about it. I'm sorry, Mac users. I love you guys too, but seriously.
I'm kind of interested in the fact that you have to use a PS4 controller, and I don't think there's official drivers for the PS4 and PC yet, is there?
Nope.
You have to get the weird...
That's what I was hoping for.
So does that just not work out of the box if you try to play it? I haven't messed with it.
Neither have I. I wouldn't know.
I'd assume you need to download those unofficial drivers to get that to even work.
Oh, they have to have a workaround because they're officially doing it, so...
I'm going to say that their program has custom drivers that only works with their program.
Just like the Xbox app, am I right, guys?
The Xbox controller works with everything. It's fine.
No, it doesn't. Not the old... Oh, fuck. Almost there, guys. Almost. Keep it up, Sony. But next news story is going to be the fan-run vanilla World of Warcraft server, which got shut down by Blizzard. Now, Bert, you have the most experience with World of Warcraft out of all three of us, so why don't you go ahead and give us the rundown on that one?
Well, there's not too much to say, but Nostalrius, which was a vanilla server, which is World of Warcraft without any of the expansions, which obviously you can't play that anymore because the official servers are all updated to whatever the latest expansion is as it goes on, and a lot of people prefer the older version. So fans make these legacy servers, as they're called, and they let people play on them for free because Blizzard's not doing it. But as those get more popular, Blizzard takes notice, and they kind of have to take those down.
But why, though?
Because they have to protect their IP.
But no, but why, though? It's
I mean, that's
they're
really
not
all
losing
there is to
money,
it.
Right?
Not really. I mean, there's a case to be said that you know, they're not going to pay for Live if they can play this for free, but... I mean, they're totally different games.
I was going to say, wouldn't that mean that their new updates are shit if people are going back to the old ones?
That's exactly what it means.
Oh. Did I actually call that?
I mean, that's the general consensus, yeah.
Is that why you stopped playing?
I mean, I stopped playing many times.
You've never truly stopped playing. You're still playing it right now as we do this podcast, actually.
No, I am done. I didn't even play this either, though, but that was worth mentioning.
I was going to say, actually, what was the last, like, expansion you stopped at?
I mean, the current one. I've played at least all of them for, like, a month, at least. Mostly because friends always want to go back in, try it out, and then they just burn out after, like, a month or two. Because it's just not what it used to be.
Oh. Is it kind of like the situation with, Is it like the Phantasy Star Universe to Phantasy Star Online?
I didn't play much of Universe, so... But I guess, yeah, imagine if, like, you couldn't play the original PSO anymore, and it could only play Universe.
Yeah, okay.
And like fans would make the servers for the old one instead.
Kinda and like they Blueburst. Did.
But
yeah, I was gonna say.
In this case, Sega would take it down.
The problem is Sega hasn't released like a Phantasy Star in the States for a long ass time, so they don't give two shits.
Yeah,
that's a story for another day. Speaking of companies cracking down on shit, Bandai Namco is looking to trademark finishing move. Now, what could that mean for everything that uses the term finishing move?
Bandai Namco loves their trademarks.
They do, don't they?
They had that loading screen game trademark where you can't have a game in the loading screen.
Wait, what? Oh, yeah, from like Tekken 3, right? They had Galaga and stuff like that? I remember
that eventually lapsed, so people can do it now. But they They also have those like sound effects during training mode or something like that.
Oh, the musical cues.
Yeah, like no one else can use those or something.
Wow.
I don't know. Bandai Namco is pretty nuts.
Dude, real talk though, I love games and loading screens. I think everything should have something like that. Even if you don't play the minigame, just having something there to do while the game's loading, I love that shit. I've always wondered why no other game did that, but now I know. I didn't know that Namco did copyright on that.
Wow. Did start seeing it soon, though, because now that copyright has ended.
Well, I mean, hell, we're seeing it in Splatoon. Squid Jump, anyone?
What?
Squid Jump.
Oh, right. Yeah.
A little minigame on the little Wii U pad whenever the game's loading.
Yeah, I was going to say, that was something.
That was something. Not much, but yeah.
I forgot about that, because I normally don't look at the gamepad.
You're too busy fucking killing people with shit.
While it's loading.
Well, yeah. I don't even know what you do when you're loading shit.
Don't worry about it. I don't want to know.
That's fine. And moving to the next story, Capcom delaying Umbrella Corps to June. Umbrella Corps, sorry. For some reason, I always read it as Corpse. I know it's Core, but...
It could be Corpse, because it's corporations.
No. Okay, think, but... Right? No, the pronunciation is Core. It's always been Core.
There's two. If it's corporations, it's Corpse.
Okay, before
I
you start...
I thought it was Core.
But, like, the Navy Corps...
Oh, God. Are you guys really going over this?
No. This is important. See, I have to prove that I'm right. It's corporations,
you're allowed to say Corpse.
I'm pretty sure it's Core, regardless. Name one time Corpse has ever been used, because Corpse...
I'm saying you can, because it's short for corporation.
No, because even then it'd be like Navy Corps, Umbrella Corps.
It's not
it's always
Corporation, though, I don't think.
Navy Corps, right.
Don't worry about it.
You would never say Navy Corps. Okay.
You can, though. It's fine.
You just can't. It's wrong. Go on, Scoots.
It does nothing for me.
I was good, yeah, because this is more you two. You two are the ones that have dived head first into the rest.
This game
it does
garbage,
nothing for me.
No, screw
exactly.
You both. You guys played Operation Raccoon City.
I didn't play it willingly.
You played it though. You
I
both
was
played
forced.
It. Mm-hmm. Why don't you go ahead and tell me about that experience, boys?
There's nothing to experience with that. That needs to be said.
Let me ask you though, you both, since you both played it together. I was barred from that experience. Thankfully, I have good taste in games like, Brave Fencer Musashi. But, like, how does it compare to Resident Evil 6? Like, is it Resident Evil 6 with multiplayer? But not Mercenaries, because that's actually good.
No, it's more of a traditional third-person shooter type thing. But bad.
I don't understand how you can ruin it. Like, third-person shooters are so, like...
There's so many of them, and so many have perfected it, so when a bad one comes, it's easy to notice.
How do you screw up a formula that's been perfected? Like, even if you made the most average third-person shooter game, you can't freak it up. How do you do that?
I mean, you can if your studio's not good or inexperienced.
Dude, Sega managed to make a competent third-person shooter with Binary Domain... And they've never done a shooter before.
Look at Dead Souls.
That was their first. It was wonky as shit, but it was playable. Yakuza Dead Souls was wonky. I'll be the first to admit it's wonky as shit, but it's playable.
That was Umbrella, whatever the hell it was called.
Umbrella Core?
We got to the end of it, so it had to have been playable.
So I guess in June, I'm sorry guys, you got delayed. Scooch, you're gonna have to fucking cancel your pre-order or something. I'm sorry. Can we expect a video from you two on Umbrella Corps?
I will take my $30 elsewhere.
No?
Same here.
I didn't realize it was only 30 though, so that's at least...
That's what I was going to mention.
Softens the blow a little bit.
What if we all pitch in?
They even know.
They don't want
to... I thought it was going to be a free-to-play thing at first.
You mean like a... What's that one free-to-play game on Wii U? What's it?
Oh,
Reavers?
Isn't that
whatever?
Out soon?
I think it... Oh.
I think we need to play that.
We're going to have to play that.
Have you seen that thing's frame rate? Holy crap.
I haven't. Dude, it can't be... Dude, nothing will ever get to the top multiplayer shit on Wii U like Devil's Third.
You haven't even
which
played
we all
that,
should have played.
So I don't want to hear it.
I played it.
You did not.
Yes, I did. I did. You guys can't prove I didn't.
To all the viewers, you must tell Wolfie to play that game.
I have. I have recorded footage.
All right, put a video up.
It's not complete because I had to return the game to get another game.
That's all right. I just want to see some of
no,
the
I'm not
sweet
uploading
Wolfie
a part
action.
When there's no, not until there's more parts to
you
go.
Put it up as a hidden video and link it in the description so everyone can see how amazing this game is that you
no,
think.
Never. I would never do that. Man, viewers, so I'm sorry. I'm sorry, but it's just not going to happen. But you know what will happen? Bayonetta might be banned at Spain. Smash scene.
Your transitions are the worst. Just
oh,
that
Bert,
there.
You know what, Bert? I think that was probably the safest, best transition we could have done. So, for
guess
all
what?
The salty bitches out there, including these two guys here that don't
that
play
skates?
Bayonetta.
She's already been banned.
Oh, did they officially ban her?
I believe so.
Oh, my main.
At least, according to the Reddit, it was.
Oh.
But then again, there's a lot of people that are, like, really salty, and they could just say whatever.
I'm salty. That's my main.
Of course it is. You need her to carry you.
Oh, sure. I only played fucking King Dedede for fucking years and got my ass bodied by the... Fuck you, Bert. I deserve a talk to you.
Why are you so aggro?
Because you people like you're the reason she got banned.
I can care less if she's banned.
You totally... I saw you sign the petition in Spanish to get it from theater banned.
Yes.
You're the worst.
I only failed Spanish, so that I can do this.
Yeah, all you need to know is... all you need to know to write down is C.
But anyways,
I want her banned.
The whole story is... this one Spanish tournament that was doing Smash Brothers, they were trying to ban Bayonetta due to the fact that she has so many moves that none of the characters can handle. Or, you know, deal with. But Zero was showing different ways to get around her moves.
I'm calling bullshit on that, though. I'm sorry. It's just... Why? Why? It didn't stop people from fucking playing Diddy Kong in the first thing. Everyone was fine with fucking Hoo-Ha. And then whenever fucking Sheik was fucking godly and no one could touch that character,
well, even
she's
you agreed,
fine.
Even you agreed that she doesn't play like a Smash character.
No.
And she breaks everything.
No, but I never once said ban her. I just said buff everybody up so they're at least able to keep up with her. She's
the
only character that can
combo.
Change
the game, probably.
Yeah. But Bayonetta comes out and everyone's getting their nuts in a twist because she's... I think it's mostly because they're butthurt that, you know, oh, it's a third-party guest character. And no, not even that. It's because it's a third-party guest character they didn't want. Because everybody... Go on.
I don't think the, like, people who play that as a competitive game, care if it's a third party or not.
No.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's more or less that her moveset is just ridiculous.
But even Cloud, when he first came out, was fucking great too.
So great.
Really good.
But he didn't change the game.
He did in doubles. He's still the best character in doubles.
And he could in 0 to 100 someone, or 0 to death someone. That's probably one of the main reasons.
Yeah, but I don't know.
I mean, I don't know. I don't follow the scene.
No,
I just
no.
I play it once a month. So there's that.
I like Bayonetta. I don't want to see there characters get banned. I love Bayonetta. I think she's one of the coolest like characters in that game. And I love how they kept her really close to her design. Like if you can do her combo shit, you can do it. It's just I don't know. I'm salty. I'm not gonna front. I'm super salty on this matter, as you can clearly tell.
Again.
It's Kokonoi and Blaze Blue all over again, who I also like.
Why do you always
Super
play these
Bowl.
Broken characters?
Oh, we can't say Super Bowl. We gotta edit that part out. We will get sued.
You
we can't
Super
afford.
Ball.
Super Bowl. We can say that. God, the characters I like always wind up being broken.
I know. Cats are awesome. What can I say?
Vanetta's not. Fuck, she has the shit. Not in Smash, she can't.
Nope. That's why she's banned. They want her to be a cat.
She can turn into a bird. That's fine.
She also has the butterfly Umbra. Oh, man. Oh, Vanetta.
But then again, you're not the only one that's, like, butthurt about that.
I'm super
butthurt. The whole community just got, like, split in half because of that.
My butt hurts so bad from this news. All right.
I think Smash is the only, like, competitive scene that has banned characters lately, yeah? Like, in the last year since Street Fighter 2, Zakuma.
Let's see. In
That's the last time I can remember a character being banned.
in Melee, it was, I don't think any character was banned in Melee. It was just always those top four.
It was Meta Knight.
In Meta Knight and Brawl. That's Brawl. Mm-hmm. And then in, they lifted the ban. And then in 4, I think they were, I think they were originally talking about Diddy or something. I can't remember. But Bayo is the first in 4, as far as I remember anyway. But yeah, enough about
that. It was only that Spanish tournament. Everywhere else is not.
Yeah, it's not like it's global.
Yeah. Everyone else is
getting
good.
A lot of people are vocal about it.
I mean, Zero fucking gave some good advice on how to beat her. She's not impossible. She's light as shit.
I just think it's ridiculous that they did that after, like, you know, she hasn't even been out for like 4 months.
Yeah, exactly. It's like whenever if Street Fighter V introduced, say, Alex, and he was like, he had like a fucking strong ass, godly ground game, and you know, basically if he was Chun Li. And he was, like, so good, and everybody's, like, the second week, they're like, nah, this character's too good.
Well, he, like, technically there's... broke the game.
Well, yeah, but we'll get into that. No, actually, we won't. We don't have that on the docket. Can you believe that shit? This is a bad transition, but Alex having that glitch or whatever in Street Fighter V that allowed you to play a previous version?
Yeah.
Previous versions of characters? How does that happen?
No QA?
We didn't test this shit when we released Alex, so...
Bad programming?
Yeah. Well, to be fair, this is, like, their first time doing a free-to-play, like, free-to-release character deal. I'll cut them some slack on that.
And
but...
they messed up all over the place, especially with that store. Like, they couldn't even release the character correctly, so they're just free.
He's just free. He's been free since, like, what, the end of March?
They're never going to figure this thing out.
It's been 17 days and there's still no word on the April character.
It's not going to happen until like the end of the month.
17
Yeah, I was going to say, from what I've seen, it's going to happen at the end of the month. Same thing with Killer Instinct.
Yeah,
the Killer Instinct is like, hey, guess what? Here, this is what's happening.
But they did let you know.
Yeah, exactly.
They're
letting you know. Capcom's just like,
it's the end of the month. Us know yet because they don't know yet.
But that's the thing, if they don't know, tell us. It's not good PR, but at least don't keep us in the fucking dark.
They'll tell us if it doesn't hit the date. That's all that
matters.
Man,
this whole Street Fighter V thing is a mess, which Ono responded to because of the lack of content, which was awful. And I think it goes without saying, this is pretty much, I fucked up. I know I fucked up. Please understand. That's pretty much all that was said on that matter.
Well, you really can say.
We've pretty much already covered this in the last podcast, I believe, didn't we? We went over this already, right? Like, what we would have done differently for 5, like Street Fighter 5 launch and all that?
I don't know. That was two weeks ago.
We mentioned something about it, yes.
I think we did. I don't know if we want to go over it again, but yeah, pretty much they shit the bed on this one. It's a good game. I could say this many times. It's a good fighting game, but Jesus, man.
I still think it's going to be Guile.
Oh, yeah, it's definitely going to be Guile. Sucks for me, though. I thought it was going to be Balrog. I was really hoping for Balrog.
Sucks for you. I don't get my character until, like, second to last.
Baby, you got Chun-Li.
I don't want to play
Chun-Li. Yeah, well, guess what? You still got her. You still have her. And fuck you, dude. I'm not getting Q till God knows when. I want Q.
Hey, you can use that mod.
It's true.
I don't have it on PC, though.
That means you gotta play Vipson.
I don't play Vipson, but I'll do it. I will do it.
Then after you beat people, you gotta use your bips and dollars.
All the bips and dollars to buy the
car. You can't. The store isn't available.
Yeah, you can't. The store's not even working.
Yeah, so it all fails.
It's an endless loop of bullshit. Like, what? When are they going to fix the store, man? Dude, I'm not going to lie. There's two premium costumes they have. The Zangief and the Armika. Premium costumes look really good. I love the Macho Man look for Zangief. And I love the T-Zoc kind of inspired bird wrestler for Armika, but I'm not paying $4 for those. That's expensive. That's super expensive. Like, how much were the costumes in for Street Fighter 4?
They're about the same. I think you had to buy them in packs, though.
Yeah, that's the thing. Can you buy? They haven't really said anything. Shit. And I would actually be okay if I could use my bips and dollars to get premium costumes, which I know they would never do. But come on, those costumes they actually put time into at least a little bit.
Kind of, you know what they should do with that?
Go ahead.
They should have it to where when you play rank for a certain amount of time, or just play the game for a while, that you should earn bips and dollars that way. They should just be like, hey, here's a free $5 and bips and dollars to use on the store.
Oh no, Scoots, they would never do that, especially not when they don't have a fucking rage quit like thing to stop people from rage quitting.
Hey,
so
they're working on that again.
Hey, yeah. Scoots, what's the last time they said anything on that?
You know what?
They said they were talking about it not too long ago.
You know what they're gonna do? They're gonna have Nia from Pokemon or Pokken. This is gotta tell you. Rage quitting is bad. We will penalize you.
That's hilarious. That's the fact that they released this game and there's no rage quit. Like, every fighting game has something like that. Blaze Blue fucking... The first Blaze Blue had the, one of my favorite things for that happened to rage quitters, which is whenever you rage quit a lot in Blaze Blue, your name would appear red. So that was like, hey, guess what? This guy right here... Play with him if you dare. His name's Red. He disconnects a lot. I think your name should get like something on it if you rage quit. Not accidental. If it happens a few times, yeah, disconnections, that's fine. But like, if you have a lot of quits before the match is over, they should put something next to your name, or at least make your name red, or make it easy to discern the legit players from the bullshit ones. Really. Is there any other fighting games that you guys know that have like some sort of rage quit thing? That's good.
Yeah, it does. They have a like rage quit hell or something like that, where only the people who rage quit play against other rage quitters.
So they can never truly escape because they can never get a match in.
And that broke at one point. Like everyone got sent there.
Oh fuck! Do you know if you're in rage quit hell?
No.
Oh.
I believe it shows in your icon. Like it shows bars or something weird.
I do remember, think I read that a while back, yeah. And then they had Smash has one too, I think. It's not apparent, but apparently they said something along the lines of if you get reported a lot or something like that, if people like leave negative feedback or whatever every time you have a match.
Oh, so it's the Street Fighter V method? You have to report in that one also.
Yeah, but to be fair, it's actually built into the game. You don't have to actually like record footage of people rage quitting on you. So, yeah. While we're still on the subject of fighters, we're going into Kingdom Hearts, King of Fighters 14. And there's, since last week, there's been four characters added. The character, I'm going to butcher this name, Mui Mui. Mui Mui. And Kukri. AKA Gaara. So,
all right.
Those are the first two characters added last week. Mui Mui. Mimi. Mimi. Appears to be... what am I making... What is this?
Zhao Lao. Zhao Ling from Tekken.
Who?
The girl who fights backwards and has the Phoenix Dance.
But basically, that character's based on SNK's Panchika machines.
That's... Okay.
Wait, Mui Mui is?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. That's what it was.
I don't really know anything about Panchico, so...
Who does, Bert? They don't exist here.
Hey, Tin Man, maybe you need to explain what a Panchico machine is.
I'm glad you said that, Scoots, because Pachinko machines are awful, awful things that have caused probably one of the best gaming companies, used to be good, Konami, to just quit gaming entirely. Shit the bed, burn the bridge, spit in every fan's face, and just Pachinko it up. Konami is who I'm talking about. So
it's okay. They got Yu-Gi-Oh, so
they do.
All is fine with Konami, apparently.
As long as they have Yu-Gi-Oh and Pachinko, nothing can go wrong. Nothing. Oh, and Metal Gear Online. They can't take that away from them. But Mui Mui is from Pachinko, and apparently, according to Bert, she's some sort of weird. What?
Well, she's just like the Chinese. Typical Chinese style fighter.
Oh, she's the Jam, like from Guilty Gear. She's the Wayou type. Yep. The Fei Long. Okay. And then the other dude is just Scoots' character, the cool guy in the hood, the Kingdom Hearts character, the Organization 13 guy, got it memorized. Sandman. Fucking Kukri. I'm not even gonna bother trying to say the names right anymore. Kukri. Just Kukri. Kuku.
He'll be able to pronounce the next two.
But anyways, that character is pretty awesome. The way
I think
his
he's
design.
Lame. I but think I he's really
you,
lame.
You just don't. You don't like the sand.
I don't like sand. The next two characters that were added in Kingdom Hearts. Fuck. Fucking shit. I'm
okay.
Losing it.
I'll say it. Just the next two characters for King of Fighters 14 is Mai and Banderas. Everyone who has played a King of Fighter, or even Fatal Fury, know who Mai is. The female ninja, really, really controversial.
Even if you haven't played it, you probably know who it is.
You've seen the design somewhere. Hey, Scoots, let me ask you something. Is Mai the character that people lost their shit over that they didn't add in 12? And they were like,
yes.
No Mai, no Bai.
That's where that meme comes from.
Mm-hmm. There's Mai, everyone.
And then
Go on.
Go ahead.
I'm gonna be completely real. I don't care for Mai as a character or a design. I know I just lost like all the King of Fighters. I've lost all the King of Fighters fans and the Kingdom Hearts fans by saying that. But yeah, I've never truly cared for Mai, so I don't see the appeal.
Maybe you'll care for Banderas.
I do care about Banderas.
South American wannabe ninja.
The Brazilian wonder with dreadlocks and another ninja.
He looked cool to me.
He's stalking Mai. How is that for like... Now Mai's getting a taste of her own medicine after stalking Andy for so many years. Wait, did she stalk him or did she just freaking like... Husbando him.
Did both.
she stalked him and made him her husband at the same time.
Trying to make him her husband.
Oh, they're not married yet? I thought they were. I thought canon-wise they were already married.
Away from her.
Wait. What? Okay, I may be wrong here. I don't have my SNK lore up to date, but wasn't Garou Mark of the Wolves like years after, and wasn't there a Andy type character in that? No, wait, they weren't related. I thought that was like their
kid
or something.
You're thinking of the ninja kid. Yeah.
He uses Andy's like a mix. Never mind. Sorry, I got my shit mixed up. But Banderas, yeah, he's okay. He's better than the sand guy. he just looks. I can't say much because ninja characters are hit and miss with me.
But Banderas looks like he's from, he's a descendant from one of the characters from, Samurai Showdown.
Which one?
Hanzo. The ninja character.
I was gonna say, weren't there multiple ninjas in that game, though? I can't remember which one
it's
is
It's
the which.
One that wears black armor. Like, heavy black armor.
I guess,
I don't know his last name.
Yeah. I guess we'll find out if there's a story mode in King of Fighters. I did it! King of Fighters 14. If there is a story mode, we'll find out more about him and what his deal is. For now, all we know is he stalks Mai, and Mai is having none of it.
Just wants a ninja master to learn real ninja shit.
And he also has his own dojo, which has no students. This is the other Japanese trope of, I opened a dojo, I don't have any students. Maybe if I enter a tournament, I get students trope.
Like Lara.
Exactly.
And yeah. Dan. To a lesser
and Dan.
Extent.
Yep.
I gotta say, for Dan, the best form of Dan is when he signs a little autograph of him and he throws it at the person.
I do like that.
That's the best form of it.
That's the best. That's enough of King of Fighters. Now we're going to move on to one of my personal favorite indie games of all time, The Binding of Isaac Afterbirth Plus. There are updates coming soon. Get hype. Okay, real talk, guys. Do either one of you play Binding of Isaac? Like,
nope.
You guys have hinted. No?
I have like 9 hours in the first game. That's about
it. I was going to say, I played a bit of it on the PlayStation 4. Guess what? Coming out for PlayStation 4 here soon.
I don't see how you play that game on a controller. I can't do it.
It's like the easiest thing to do.
I can't. I have like 300 hours and using a keyboard. I can't controller it. It's not natural. But yeah, this update, I love when they do updates for the Binding of Isaac games. It's just like, I haven't even discovered half the shit, like all the items that you can get, like the upgrades, and they're going to add more combinations. I love this game. I love being able to just, I think I'm more of an arcade type player, like gamer, because sometimes when I just want to play a game real quick, I just want to in and out. I want to pop a game open, do one run, okay, run ended, that's fine. Real quick, in and out, no problem. Maybe
I
want to play another
one too.
Yeah.
I mean, grew up with arcades as well, and I see where you're coming from with that.
Yeah. Because, you know, sometimes I don't have time to just sit there and sink, you know, into like a... That's usually why I don't play a lot of RPGs these days, because I just don't have the patience or the time to sit there and just immerse myself like I used to. I got too much shit to do. But, yeah. Did I mention that he's also taking suggestions for items? So, if you haven't seen the Reddit thread, please go there and start doing suggestions. I'm gonna put my own suggestion in there, and I bet you guys can't guess what it is. If it gets in, I'm gonna mark out
is
so
it,
hard.
Is it a bad wolf hat?
It is. No, you almost had it though. It's a wolfy hat. Like, it's like a wolf hat, and whenever you wear it, I was thinking, like, I don't know what the item's gonna do. I was gonna say it illuminates like nighttime, not night, Curse of Dark levels, but the candle already does that. So I was trying to think of like, what could the hat do? But yeah, I want to suggest the wolf hat thing for Isaac, and I want it to be called the wolfy hat. He won't even know it's referencing. It'd just be a clever self-insert, and I'll be, oh god, I just want that. So I will be in the Reddit thread after this podcast is done. That's pretty much it for Binding of Isaac news. Seriously, though, if you guys have not tried Binding of Isaac Afterbirth, Bert, I know Scoots has played it. You need to play that. It's so good. It's such a step up from... Why don't you... you know what? Never mind. Next news story. Telltale Games teases a very different project over Twitter. Me having the most experience with the Telltale games, I can safely say... What's it mean for a different project? Does it mean it's not going to be a story-driven, your choices affect the outcome sort of deal?
What would you like to see them do?
I don't know. I don't know what Telltale's capable of, to be honest. Like, all I've seen is them do the story stuff. Unless you're asking what kind of story-based game, like, what IP would I want them to revisit or visit?
Both, I guess. Well, I meant the other way, like, just game style.
That's the thing. I don't want to say something like a character action game, because I don't know if they could pull it off. But if it's in the same vein as, like, you know, their Walking Dead or Back to the Future games, I would want them to do... What's an IP that lends itself well to that? I don't know. I really don't... I don't... think there's a lot of games I want to see done in that style. I would This has nothing to do with Telltale, but I would love a sequel to Until Dawn. If Telltale can get their hands on that, then more power to them.
I'm sure that studio that made Until Dawn's still doing something now.
Oh, dude. Like, Until Dawn, they said, it did some numbers for them. They, like, it's a super easy sell to casuals, too, because I've noticed that I've been able to sell that game really well. Casuals who are like, I want a game I can play with, like, you know, my girlfriend or whatever, and I'm like, well, it's not multiplayer per se, but it's blah, 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 and kids up in a cabin on a mountain, and you gotta survive a night with a killer in the mountains, and like, oh, that sounds like a movie. I'm like, yeah, it's pretty much like a movie. Until Dawn was probably the biggest surprise of last year that Bert and I went through. I liked it.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
But yeah, I mean, Telltale does the same thing, but Until Dawn just was like, yeah, we can do what Telltale does, but with a budget, we can do a lot more. So, I don't know. I'd like an episode 3 to Walking Dead. I know it's going to be hard to pull off with the way they ended it with, like, there's like 4 or 6 potential endings for season 2.
It wouldn't be that hard.
Yeah, I mean, if they just retcon, yeah. It just, no, to make it, like, story-wise make sense for Clementine or whatever to do whatever is necessary from wherever you wind up with, spoiler alert, skip forward to blank blank to avoid Walking Dead season 2 spoilers. Yeah, just put that in there. But if Clementine winds up like Kenny at the fort, whatever that was, how on earth could they do like a opening that has the same kind of, you know, context as Clementine going to the back to the place where
they'd be different at the start?
Maybe,
but they just all meet up at a certain point.
Oh, okay, yeah. Because like, and then there was also the third ending where you don't go with either Kenny or Crazy Chick.
Yeah,
and you, I. Okay,
like, they would like, if you went with Kenny, they'd write him out eventually, they'd write out the girl, and they'd write out whoever else, and then they just start to a point where they can be fresh.
But what if you killed them? Because there's both
already.
Endings.
Okay. And they don't have to worry about it.
I real talk, last thing I'm going to say on Walking Dead, episode 3, if they ever do it, I want to get rid of the baby. I hate babies.
That's
they are
the
worst. The
main focus of that game.
They are the worst narrative things.
It's the
ever.
One thing that's constant in all the endings.
Ever! I know. I just hate... I can name, like, at least 5 things off the top of my head that are ruined by babies. Ruined.
Hang on.
Okay, you want
I'm
me to
curious.
Go?
This is gonna be yeah. awesome.
Okay, Walking Dead. And not just this game. I can name 2 instances. Walking Dead the game and Walking Dead the show. If you saw the season finale I talked about last week, you would know what I mean by a baby fucks everything up. They're the worst. That's one example. Second example, Rugrats. How do you fuck up a show about babies? Add a baby. You know what I mean? You know I'm right. You remember Dill? Dill? That fucking monstrosity? The baby that's actually a baby? No one remembers that character. I do, though. That was the worst. Because it was a show about babies learning the world and blah, 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 whatever. But then they had an actual baby that can't talk and it just shits itself and spatters all over the place and makes a bunch of baby noises. Worst. Worst. That's another example. Third example, Fairly Odd Parents. Poof. Worst thing. Baby. There you go. You don't, Bert, you don't know what that is. Do you even know what Fairly Odd Parents is?
I know what Fairly Odd Parents is. I don't remember any babies.
Guess what? Cosmo and Wanda had a baby. Poof. It's now the worst show. It's awful. Fourth example, real life. Having a baby in real life is the worst thing ever. It will ruin your life. It will ruin it. Fifth example, Dragon Ball Z. Bulma was great till she had a baby. And then that baby grew up to be something cool. But that, well, as he was a baby, fucked up. Hate it. Hate Trunks as a baby. Worst thing. There, I've named 5 examples of babies. Speaking of babies, the director of Final Fantasy XV has discussed potential PC versions.
What does that have to do with babies?
Because he's a big baby.
I was
really,
tell you
I'm
mine.
Really riled up too. I'm sorry. Go on.
I was gonna tell you Metroid the Other M.
Shit, you're right. Oh my God, Scoots!
I thought you were gonna say that.
Oh my God, I can't believe I missed that. Oh, the baby. I can't. Oh, Bert, Scoots, Bert, Scoots. I'm just taking myself out of the podcast. I don't deserve to host this anymore. I can't believe I missed the most obvious thing. Scoots, you're taking over. Good job. Metroid Other M, I'm done. Just take over the Final Fantasy thing, whichever one of you wants to do that. I'm taking a knee now.
Okay. Okay, basically, Final Fantasy 15 director discussed a potential PC version of the game. And basically, he mentioned that if they were going to do a PC version, which he's interested in, he said there was probably going to be more things to it than the console version.
Yeah,
like maybe like filters and stuff like that. And
well, it's more interesting that they said if they did it, it would be the superior version, and that they would incorporate things that they were forced to abandon on the console limitations.
Yeah,
and that, like they'd build it from the ground up, which sounds awful because that game took how many years to make?
Well, to be fair, if we're counting the initial Final Fantasy 13 versus initial reveal, well, no, because didn't it go? It completely went overhaul. It's so they
still
dropped
the same thing.
But they dropped a build. That's different.
It's still the same thing, though.
But if they know what they're going for, then the build up should be less. I think.
It's gonna be a very long time until this PC version comes out.
I understand where you're coming from completely, because Jesus, it took what, almost two gens to get this game. So yeah,
I mean, what they're saying is like the right words. It's definitely what they should do. But
right,
it's gonna take a while.
It will, but would it be worth it, Bert? You being the PC dude here,
yes.
you love when it's done correctly, right?
If they do it correctly, yeah, like that'd be amazing.
Yeah, so it'll be worth the wait.
But
potentially,
they have a very spotty track record with their PC.
I was gonna say, speaking of PC, Final Fantasy IX came out for PC on Steam.
It did.
Want to
tell us
about
it
at all?
No.
I messed around with it.
How's the port?
It's actually not bad. The only thing that bothers me is the smudgy backgrounds, but overall, it's alright.
Then again, that was a pre-rendered background game, wasn't it?
It just looks weird whenever all the normal, like, NPC characters, and of course, the main characters, they're all high-resed. Then everything in the background, it just doesn't look right. You definitely can tell the characters are there.
It's like, because they're standing on top of a pre-rendered background.
Yeah.
It's awful. I know. Yeah? You know what game didn't have that problem, though?
Don't even say Brave Fencer.
Can I say Musashi?
Yeah, Samurai Legend.
Fuck. God. Ugh. Moving on. New Legend of Zelda to be released on the Wii U NX/NX. Has a male and female link options. I know nothing of Zelda. I leave this to either one of you.
This is a rumor also.
It is? Oh, yeah,
this is a rumor. So how do you feel about that, Bert?
I think it's awesome. They should definitely do that. Because, Link has never really needed a gender, right? Like, it's never really mattered. Unless you want to do, like, a fanfic of Link and Zelda type thing.
I've done it. But not of Zelda. With Midna.
Yeah, well, you can still have that.
Aunt Minda.
Because she won't exist.
No. She exists in my world. My fanfic.
He just wants the true form, Minda.
Get that shit out of my house.
Another interesting thing is that they might have voice acting for all the characters except Link. Obviously.
Isn't that like Zelda fans for years have been like, we want voice acting. And Nintendo's like, no, you don't.
Maybe. It might be weird, but who knows?
Can I weigh in on this a little bit?
Go for it.
I welcome a female Link. I actually really want them to put, and not a fucking Linkle or whatever it's called. I want her to be called Link. I think it's totally shit that they just fucking like, what do you call it? Like they punked out at the last second. Like, oh, it can't be Link. It's gotta be Linkle. That's a good name.
They're not ready for a female Link. So
I'm ready for it. No, it'll make my Midna fanfic easier.
Well, we should just move on.
Yeah, Dark Souls 3 came out. It's pretty awesome.
That's a good headline. Did you write that yourself?
Yeah. I didn't write it.
I wonder who did.
Yeah, I wonder who. So yeah, Souls 3 came out. It is really good. All three of us are enjoying it. We've already gone over this with our week. There's nothing more that needs to be said. If you haven't tried Dark Souls, please do yourself a favor, give it a shot. It is well worth your time. and your Muns.
Play all the Souls games.
All of them.
Even two. Demon.
Except two. Skip two.
No, do, play two.
No, play two.
No, no, play in this order. Do as I say, not as I do.
Yeah, I want to hear this.
All right, ready. If you want the truest of canon, you want to play it like this. It goes something like this. Tuna Fish. Bloodborne. Dark Souls 1. Demon Souls. If you're feeling up to the task, if you don't, you just go ahead and skip that too. Then Dark Souls 3. Don't even... Dark Souls 2 doesn't even exist. That's not a thing that happened. Just... They skipped a number.
Well, I enjoy all of the games, so... Wait.
Goose knows what's up. What else came out?
Bravely Second came out, which Scoots talked about earlier. Is there...
Great game.
Is there anything else? Well, hang on. Again, me being the dumb RPG guy that doesn't know anything about RPGs, you said this is a follow-up to the Bravely First...
Default.
Bravely Default. Can I play this without having to play the first one?
Yes, it actually, like, when you first start the game, it gives you the whole recap of the first game.
Okay.
And then it starts you out immediately in a battle.
I was going to say, because the way Bert put the first game down, he's like, that game's garbage, so now he made me not want to play
it. It's not garbage. It's not bad, it's just...
It's a great game.
It had a flawed mechanic at the end.
Very flawed.
Oh.
Where they just repeat everything over and over again. And you're going through a tedious, one giant tedious task.
Real bad.
Going back and forth.
Sounds a lot like my experience with Dark Souls 2.
And speaking of another game that repeats itself.
Yeah.
You like that
wait.
One?
No, wait.
You like that one?
No. No. Oh, I see what you... Nice. I see what you did. Nice. We're talking about Nier Automata. How do you say it? Automata?
Automata.
Automata. It has a new trailer, gameplay, and character details. So, Bert, you...
I'm already worried.
What? How?
Everything they've shown has been completely linear, like levels.
But
they've not showed an open world.
Maybe the open world...
They've talked about it, though, in interviews, where they want to have, like, another boar type thing where you can ride.
I'm okay with this. Drifting boars are one of the best things about the first Nier.
But they need, like, a world for you to care about. And yeah. Not just going from level to level.
Yeah. But to be fair, the levels they have shown do look very near-ish.
Yeah.
The one they showed, and it they did the thing I don't enjoy with, and that's just Japanese, like hype videos in general, where they have the developers and... some idols and voice actors sitting there, you know, and they're like, they speak in Japanese, and then they chime in with, eh!
Well, that's because this was revealed at that concert.
Ah, yeah, I should
have remembered
that, yeah. But yeah, I liked what I saw. They showed off the slick walking. Bert, of all things, by the way, I'm bringing this up, you should be hella excited. It runs 60 frames.
Oh, yeah. It looks a platinum game.
Good. It looks so good, though. It looks... It's basically what Nier would have looked like if a competent studio had made it.
Nier's fine. Now, if you want to say Dragon Guard 3 is fucked up, then yes. I'll agree.
Dragon Guard 3 is a trip.
It reminds me. Someone at work wanted to play that game.
Hey.
Dragon Guard 3, and I just looked at him like, I don't know about this.
I love that game, but no, don't play
it. It's a great story.
I look at him, I'm like, I don't know if you can beat it.
Bert barely beat it, and he fucking hammered down on
I beat it
shit.
Twice just so I could show you it.
You did, but you nearly lost it at the end.
you were losing yourself.
That thing took like 6 to 8 hours. Fuck that thing.
It is the only time, let it be noted on record, this is the only time Bert has ever messaged me asking for, like, my spirit energy. Because that boss was wrecking him so hard. It was incredible.
It's a real dumb last thing you gotta do. Anyone who's played it would know.
Yeah. I mean, I would have played Drakengard 3. I like the story on it.
I would love it if they would just, like, Like, it still wouldn't be a great game, like, gameplay-wise, but if this, the frame rate held up. It just feels like crap to play.
Yeah.
It feels awful.
It looked awful at some parts, especially when you summon the fucking dragon.
Yeah, it's just... It's not a video game, it's a slideshow.
but a very entertaining one at that. At least it's got that going for it.
I love that game, but don't play it.
Yeah. If you want good characters, a very interesting, like, super different story. Like, I've never seen a story told quite like Drakengard 3. If you can get through the shitstorm that is the video game itself, you might be able to enjoy a bit of that. But yeah, good luck with that final thing, if you do. But yeah, Nier Automata looks great. I'm hoping from what they've showed, the gameplay looks great. It looks smooth. It's solid. The characters, interesting, I guess. But I
curious where they'll go with the story, since they're all like robots and stuff.
Yeah, it reminded me
a lot of Nier was like characters and like, I don't know, trying to, like, this planet's supposed to be like empty, no life and stuff like that. Like, everyone lives on the moon or something like that.
Yeah.
And they're sent back to Earth with robots. I don't know how they're going to handle any kind of meaningful caring of characters.
You know what the worst part is, Bert? You don't even realize this.
What?
But it sounds like the plot of a Disney Pixar movie.
What's that?
Wall-E. You've never seen that, I know. But
I don't watch movies.
The premise of that movie was Earth is wrecked from humans living on it for so long. Shit is hella polluted, so humans had to leave, and they sent robots to the Earth to clean it, and Wall-E was one of them. So he's back on Earth cleaning shit up.
Sounds almost exactly like it, though.
Yeah. I never saw the movie, but I just know, like, the plot of it. Let's see what Nier Automata has to offer on that one. I can't wait. Hopefully they do the open world thing. I agree with you on that completely. But yeah, going ahead and moving on to the Shin Megami Tensei 4 Apocalypse, which is coming to the U.S. this summer. Sorry, Europe, no news for you as of the date of this recording.
Well, it is an Atlas game, so good luck.
Yeah. Oh, man, like, Europeans, they get screwed so hard for game releases.
Atlas doesn't have a company over there.
But Sega of Europe exists over there.
Maybe they'll do something, but usually it's NIS America that brings it to them.
But the game is coming out for us. I love Shin Megami Tensei 4. I have admittedly have fallen super behind on that. I have not come remotely close to beating it, but I will be picking up Apocalypse whenever that drops this summer because I can't get enough of these games. Bert, why don't you go ahead and tell me how you feel about the Shin Megami Tensei games?
They're amazing. That whole demon talking mechanic is the greatest thing ever created.
Dude, you love that part.
There's no RNG at all.
None.
It's amazing.
Bert, you're just butthurt that you can't figure out the moon cycles and when to talk to demons and how to sweet talk your way out of battles. It's great. I am not the biggest RPG guy, as I've said many times, but I love that this game, or the Shin Megami games, like, they change it up by, instead of just, oh, random battle, mash A, kill the enemy, get out of there. No, this one makes you think, okay, there's a demon. Have you talked to this demon before? Do you have this demon on your team? Yes, talk to the demon. Oh, you have one of my friends. I'll just leave you alone then. Maybe here's a little bit of money to help you along. It's different. I like that it changes it up with the battles. Maybe
I do like all that. I just don't like the randomness of the talking encounters and stuff. It's not that bad, but like when you first start off, it can be instant death for one wrong talk type thing.
Oh yeah, but that's I want to equate Shin Megami Tensei to Dark Souls as far as RPGs go. It's hard, like the first.
Yes,
it's hard.
But like there's like luck involved in this, in a sense. It's like you can't get out of anything with skill. Like sometimes you just get fucked.
Yeah, but in all honesty, doesn't that add a bit of like
it can, sure.
Yeah, it's something to the game. It's just like,
but whenever like the most, what am I trying to kind of say? Like the most efficient way to do it is to save and then talk to them, and then if it fails, just like reload, try again.
That's, yeah.
That shouldn't be a faster way of doing things than waiting for the little death thing, going in there, having to talk to the dude, getting revived. It's faster to just turn the game off and start again. That's no good.
But Bert, wouldn't you say the same thing about Dark Souls? Whenever you die, you have to restart from the place that you were at before. And Fire Emblem, if you fuck up and character dies, you gotta reset. It's your punishment.
You can keep going.
Yeah, but it's generally something people do. But I think it adds a challenge.
It's your fault. Not always your fault in Shin Megami.
I like that element. I understand where you're coming from completely, but I like it.
I'm glad it exists. It's not for me.
It's not for you. I just wanted to give you shit on that. Just get that shit out in the open.
Boy, Wolfie, you would totally love Persona 1 and 2.
You really, really Scott, want me and Bert to play those games.
I'm not going there.
Just saying, that mechanic is in those two games.
He, just to put this out there for you pleasant viewers and listeners.
I did that for the fun of it.
Scoots loves Persona 1, and we love Scoots for loving Persona 1 and 2. But
I don't like Persona 1.
He brings
like Persona 2.
He brings up Persona 2 every time we're talking about Shin Megami Tensei related things, and he's like, "Well, Persona 2 though." And we're like, "No, no though." It's every time. We love you, Scoots. keep loving Persona 2 like you do. Maybe one day Bert will play it.
It's okay. I'll just go to his place and we'll play it together.
Please do. Goody. Put a video up. I'd love to watch it. So that is it. But going on to actually, this was gonna be kind of like an indie section for a little bit. Just two games coming up, and that's, I don't know if either one of you saw the Delusional game, which is an upcoming 2D.
Never.
It's a 2D beat 'em up where you're looking for a child killer. I want to call this the Punisher Simulator. It's like Hotline Miami, but in like 2D and very zoomed out. It looks interesting. It's missing something for me though. It's got my attention, but it needs a little something more. Do you know what I mean? If you ever look at it, You kind of look at it, and I like what I'm seeing. But when I see it in action, it's just there's something missing. It needs some something, like.
Life bars.
Oh God, his arm got ripped off.
Yeah, you tear people up in that game. You literally rip people apart. There's something it's missing though. Like Hotline Miami, when you look at it, you just watch and you're like, yeah. You can feel like hits and it looks meaty and it's like, you know, when you knock someone down and then you kill them by stomping on their head, you know, feedback. It looks like it's missing feedback. That's what it looks like to me. Like the hits don't seem like, you know, hits. That's one of my favorite things in gaming is good feedback. Like one of my best examples is Streets of Rage 2. The sound effects in that game, oh, they're meaty. Like when you hit somebody, it makes that nice juicy like noise, you know, and you get that combo going, you hear multiple of those and it feels like you're actually doing damage to the people. I like good feedback when you hit things, when you take a hit and interacting with environments. I love it. That's what I think it's lacking, but I'll definitely look into this game. It might be a playthrough for the channel Delusional. I could be wrong just watching in action, but that's what I came up with. You guys have anything you want to say about it?
Nope.
All right. Nothing. All right. Next game one on the indie list was Sophie's Curse. Bert? Mm-hmm. It's an indie jump scare horror where you have to keep the lights on.
Oh, boy.
Guess who's gonna be joining me in that playthrough?
Not me.
You are. I'm only doing it with Bert because he hates with all of his heart and soul and being. Scary things. So
it wouldn't work with me. I find that stuff hilarious.
Scoots has
I just laugh.
He has an iron will. So that's like his character trait. He can't be startled. So I gotta bring the startliest, the guy who literally will die if something touches his shoulder at night.
You're not even going to play this anyway.
I would.
No, you're not.
Why not? Why wouldn't I play this?
Because it's only on Steam.
I played on Steam. I played Five Nights at Freddy's, and that's on Steam. I played all four, all five, including Five Nights at Freddy's World.
Oh, it's only $5.
Yeah, and
sorry, the
thing, will.
Yeah, the thing is, what it reminds me of is Five Nights at Freddy's.
Wait,
2.
Why is this in the news?
Because I wanted to bring it up because, are you talking about on the docket for the podcast?
Well, I mean, this game is like a month old now.
Oh, is it? I don't know. I saw it on the news articles and I thought it would be something cool to talk about. It might be a little older than I anticipated, but
I didn't know if it like had some new news or something.
It might have. Maybe a YouTuber got on it, like a popular one, like Markiplier or PewDiePie or something. Maybe that's what kind of got it up on.
Maybe. It doesn't have very many reviews, and it's very positive.
Oh, so maybe this is definitely a video that might be coming out. I got like $10 on Steam that I haven't used yet.
The more like this thing on the Steam page says Five Nights at Freddy's, Five Nights at Freddy's 4, Five Nights at Freddy's 2, Five Nights at Freddy's 3.
It's essentially that game, but you have free movement, and you have to go around this dark house and crank all the things to keep the lights on, and there's something in this house that's like pursuing you as you're doing this. It sounds interesting.
Never heard of that before.
No, it's basically, like I said, it's Five Nights at Freddy's 4. It's a bit of 4 and 2.
It's every indie horror game.
Well, not like, having to, like, freaking panic and go all over the place and, like, crank shit and keep
like
up.
It's like Slender.
Thing.
Instead of turning lights on, you're collecting pages.
But Slender, you eventually die anyway. You always die, even if you get all the pages.
Well, who knows about this one? Maybe the lights always go out.
Well, I don't know. It just seems like a fun little, oh my god, panic type thing. I'd give it a shot. It would make for a fun video with
like
face
an
cam.
Indie horror game to me.
Yeah, well, you're gonna be with me when it happens. I want you there. Don't let the listeners
first
and viewers
time
down,
said that.
And you can quote me on that. Will you be there? Come on, man.
That one.
Oh, all right. Can't take Iron Will Scoots with me. He'll freaking just laugh the entire time as I'm pissing my pants.
That'd be great.
No. It's not. I want someone else to be there to make it less embarrassing. Fine.
Bert, think of it this way. Wolfie, if he gets scared, he needs to hug someone.
I do.
You'll be that person.
You don't know. They don't know that. We could be right next to each other for all they know.
He could do like the whole like Scooby-Doo jumping in Shaggy's arms. All
right. If you
or Shaggy jumping in Scooby-Doo's arms.
Come on over, Justin, and we'll do it.
No. I don't know. This exactly. Can't be local. Oh. Okay. No, we have to. You know what? We'll talk about this off the cast. this is something to say for another time. But on the same subject. No, actually, no, that's not the same subject at all. We're talking about my upcoming game of the year, Monster Hunter Generations. They introduced new hunter styles. Have you guys seen this shit?
Yep.
Okay.
All I gotta say is Ariel. Style.
Oh, no, dude. The I like the fucking. No, Ariel is actually pretty sick too, dude. I love these styles. I love them. Bert, what are you gonna use?
None of them.
Okay. Being the stick in the mud again.
Sorry, I'm bowing out of this one.
No, Striker. Dude, this game looks awesome. I can't wait to play this. Scoots and I will be playing it, at least.
Do it.
Mm-hmm. Monster Hunter Generations. Look forward to it this summer. And finally, the last thing on the gaming docket. Splatoon's next Splatfest is gonna be SpongeBob versus Patrick. Why? I know it's... I get maybe...
You know why.
The undersea thing. I just got it.
Well, not even that, but the audience for Splatoon. And what is popular around that age range?
But...
Isn't, like, SpongeBob, like, the holy grail of everything?
It was. That's the thing. SpongeBob hasn't been funny in, like, 13 years. If
maybe
that.
For, like, you, but, like, isn't it still popular?
I don't know how. It's because Nickelodeon keeps rerunning it. It's not funny. It's awful. It
doesn't matter what you think, but like the general populace, what do they think about it?
I'm pretty sure the majority thinks the same thing. Like the new SpongeBob is awful.
Even the kids. I'm sure people around our age might think that.
Kids like anything that has like colors, and I'm not saying kids that don't, but yeah, the young.
You already went on a huge tangent about babies.
Well, babies are the worst though. That's different. Babies are awful. I'm sorry, baby listeners that are listening to this, and if you are a baby, please turn off this podcast. No babies allowed. But seriously though, like SpongeBob is, I can't be the only one that feels like. I'm sure the majority feels the same way. If you are listening and you agree or in a consensus with me that SpongeBob hasn't been good like since the first SpongeBob movie, which is like in 2003, 2004, please leave a comment and let me like back me up on this. I'm pretty sure everybody thinks the show is awful. It's just Nickelodeon. They keep playing it because it's like their money maker. But
and why does it make money? Because it's popular.
You know what, Bert? You know what else is making money and popular?
What's that?
I'm not going to say it, but you know what I'm going to say. You know what I want to say.
Before we move on, I need to know one thing.
Mm-hmm.
What team are you joining?
I'm not joining either.
Oh, you're not going to play on either, are you?
No. I mean,
You know what team I'll pick?
You're not going to become a SpongeBob queen?
When you put it like that, it's hard to resist. I don't know. Patrick Queen sounds pretty good. Sounds pretty good, too.
You know what team I'll go with?
What's that?
The Squidward team.
Is
that where you don't
team?
Play?
The third party. But I'm not joining this stupid shit team.
Maybe he'll be with Patrick.
And I guess the last thing on Splatoon was they did add the weapons, the Sheldon's picks. Do you guys have any interest in trying Splatoon anytime soon? Maybe give those new weapons. Come on, you only used one weapon the entire time you played that. You never tried new things.
Well, that's because the maps didn't try new things.
Stick in the mud, Bert. Killing the mood again.
I'm sorry, the two map rotation killed that game for me.
What about you, Scoots? You in?
Maybe.
We could do a video on that.
So we get Hammerhead Bridge, and the next thing you know, Hammerhead Bridge!
Hammerhead Bridge sucks, though. That's the worst!
Uh-huh. And then when you have to play it for 4 hours.
A baby-designed Hammerhead Bridge. It's awful. Only a baby
Why don't you just go and talk about your favorite movie?
No, this isn't my favorite movie. That was an awful transition. You talk about me and my transitions. That was awful.
I gotta keep the tone going the same way.
Gotta keep
it
going.
You set this tone.
Keep that baby train going. This is other news.
In other news, Star Wars and Rogue One gets its first trailer.
It'll be in theaters this December.
Exactly. Like you read my mind.
Y'all two can talk about that all you want.
I don't know if there's too much to talk about.
I mean, did you guys watch the trailer? What did you think of the trailer? Maybe talk about the fucking trailer. I don't know.
Someone's not happy.
I'm not happy.
Interesting. What about you, Bert? I know you've seen the trailer.
Yeah, that looked fine. But who knows what... This is like one of the first offshoots that they have, yeah?
Yeah.
Like that's not part of the main...
The first spinoff movie.
What about Star Wars Christmas?
You be quiet. I guess it takes place during the original trilogy, right?
Yeah, it takes place before A New Hope, because they're getting the Death Star plans.
Yeah, I wonder if Darth Vader will show up.
Hope so.
Like, what all they would bring back since everyone's so old now and they can't really reprise their old roles.
Darth Vader needs to return just so he can force choke a bitch.
He'd be easy to return since it's just a suit.
Exactly. And he needs a force choke a bitch. That's his thing. Chokes people.
That is his thing. He is into that.
Are you two going to see it together?
No.
I'll watch it.
Because I don't watch movies.
You like Star Wars, though. There's a difference.
Yeah, we'll see.
Okay. I just want you two to see a movie together. I think it would be great. Build that social link.
I don't think we've ever seen a movie together.
We totally did, right? With episode 8, right? Or no, 7. Damn it.
Yes, we did.
That's right.
We
yeah.
totally watched that together.
Yeah.
But did you guys have anything else to say on Rogue One?
Nope.
No, looks cool. It'd be good, I guess.
I mean, I can ask this because I know nothing about Star Wars, but did they say they were doing a sequel to whatever the new Star Wars one that came out was? The new one with, the new one?
There will be 3 new movies for that series, yeah.
Okay.
And these are like offshoots between.
Okay, oh. Basically how it's being handled is episode 7 came out already, right?
Yeah.
Then Rogue One or Rebel One comes out next. Then after that one, then it's episode 8. After episode 8, it's, I guess, another movie, another spinoff movie. I guess it's the Boba Fett movie. I'm not sure. Then after that one, they go straight to episode 9. And after episode 9, it's the last spinoff movie, which I guess is Han Solo or whatever. Huh. Probably got some order mixed
up. You know, cinematic universes.
Yeah. The SCU, the Star Wars Cinematic Universe. Basically, they're taking a page from Marvel. Building that universe with sequels and not just fucking rushing it all in one goddamn movie like one that won't be named.
No, there's a new cartoon coming out.
There is a new cartoon coming out. I'm glad you brought that up, Bert. There is a Mega Man cartoon coming soon. Maybe. There's not a lot to say. There's just a logo.
But basically, Dentsu Entertainment pretty much showed off a Mega Man logo, and then if you're not familiar with Dentsu, they pretty much do anime, I believe.
But the question is, will this be about the fighting robot Mega Man? I hope. I know they would never do like the USA cartoon like thing now that they don't exist anymore. Like, Americanizing it. There's no reason for that this day and age, but I hope they keep the design similar.
My guess is it's going to be a retelling of all the Mega Man games. Like, the original Mega Man.
I'd be okay with that.
And then just going to do, like, a cartoon series. Like, we start with Mega Man 1 all the way to freaking 9.
Wasn't there 10, though?
Oh, yeah, 10. Yeah, I forgot about 10.
Yeah, so 10.
I never really played 10, so...
Neither did I.
My guess is it's going to follow the story of Mighty No. 9.
Oh, come on, man. Come on. Too soon. It's too soon. Why would it... Mighty No. 9. Why?
They just canceled the game.
No, it's fine. It's fine. You see...
Or they'll seek more funding.
Yeah, that's... Oh, jeez.
If it gets delayed again, that's just bad. I mean, it's already bad that it delayed it the last time.
We're advertising it again in our store, so...
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm. So I'm assuming it's coming out soon. Still no pre-orders on it, but that's subject to change as we get closer to release. Keep your fingers crossed.
As I click on this, you know, website that explains the Mega Man cartoon, right?
Uh-huh.
I look to the right, and then I see Legends 3, and then I get sad. Why?
Rest in peace, Mega Man Legends
why
3.
Why they gotta, you know, just put salt in the wounds again?
It's okay, Scoots. It was never meant to happen. It's okay. Bring it in.
As we just keep, you know, whatever. I'm gonna play Mega Man Legends 2 on my fucking Wii though.
Yeah, just go ahead.
If you all.
Yeah, just do that.
Butt hurt right now.
Yeah, Scoots is a man who loves his Mega Man, and he was probably the most upset that game got canceled. It literally hurt him emotionally.
I threw a chair.
Yeah.
At the wall.
It was really scary. So
then I was crying.
Yeah. It took hours to get him back to normal, but
I wrapped myself with blankets.
Yeah. It's alright.
I was brooding in my corner.
That memory will remain forever. But you know what else is gonna remain forever?
You know what, Justin?
What's that?
Do you bleed?
Oh.
You will.
No, I tried, folks. I tried not to do it.
I did it.
He did it, though. He did it to me.
And since we're talking about superhero movies now.
No, awesome. Infinity Wars, the Avengers, Infinity Wars will be two completely different movies, which I am, I'm okay with. I'm honestly avoiding, like, reading these things, because, like, I don't want to be spoiled. I don't want to be spoiled. I'm even tempted once the trailer comes out for it. I'm probably not going to watch it. I just don't want to know anymore. 19 days till Civil War.
I already started selling the toys now.
Oh, I know. I
already had people starting to steal the toys, too.
I can't freaking wait. Oh, my God. Okay. That's all I'm going to say on Civil War. But, next news story. This one is completely my field only. I doubt either one of you have even heard of Homestuck, but Homestuck has finally ended after 7 years.
What is that?
Okay, so what is Homestuck? Homestuck is a webcomic that was updated on the daily. It was heavily based on Earthbound, as you can probably tell by the title, by the name of it. It's extremely random. Like, I want to say, it starts off, you're a kid, and you're going on a quest, your world ends, you wind up going to space, there's troll characters, it's a fucking mess. And, believe it or not, one little wolfie back in college, knew a girl who loved this shit, and she got me into it, so I read a lot of it. I stopped after, and this is for people who read the comic, but I stopped after the initial, I believe it was the first scratch, which reset the second timeline, and I kind of lost interest because it seemed to never end. It had been like 4 years, I believe, at that point, and I was like, I'm kind of losing interest. It's not getting to the point. And they killed off a lot of the characters that I actually liked, so. But I'm actually surprised to hear it finally ended. And I might eventually get around to seeing what happened at the end, because I am kind of curious to how the hell he wound up summarizing this 7-year-long story. Quick fact, you two might not know. Bert might know, because I told you already. But Hussey, I believe, was friends with Toby Fox, who made Undertale. So you can see a lot of inspiration there was given between the two. And, I can't say anything. Actually, never mind. Just know that the guy who made this was friends with the guy who made Undertale. So, yeah. That is Homestuck. Did I answer your question, Bert, by the way? Did I?
I had a question?
Yeah, you asked what Homestuck was.
Oh, sorry, I didn't really care.
Okay. Well, I appreciate the question, though. You know, makes you not seem a stick in the mud, even though you are. So the final thing in our news is the Doctor Strange movie trailer, which dropped 2 days ago. It, Scoots, you can say something, but a lot of people are saying it's Inception meets Matrix meets Dark Knight trilogy meets Doctor Strange.
There's Looks not, interesting.
It yeah. There's not much else to say, but I love the teach me line at the end, because that's just me at the end of the trailer. I'm like, please teach me the hype behind your characters. How do you do this? villain hopes, though. Dormammu or Shumagorath? I know those are the two safest ones, but Dormammu I would just love. Please do Dormammu. And
so
do him.
You know
right.
There's more.
I know there's more. I know there's a hello. But no, Dormammu is like this is like the rival dude. That's the guy. That's Doctor Strange's guy.
That's true, yeah.
Yeah. And I know they wouldn't do it, but if they're playing around with the idea of multiple universes and multiple worlds, the same worlds, I want them, if they do incorporate Dormammu, to incorporate the comic where Dormammu actually kills Doctor Strange. like where he won, because that was a I remember that was a pretty cool comic. But yeah, Doctor Strange, look forward to it. It's probably gonna he's probably gonna be in the Infinity War movie, just like everyone else. And that is all for the other news. Now on to the final part of this podcast, and that is the Q&A session. We only had one question from Jen the Wolf, and I hope you guys have thought of this, but the question was, what are your favorite games and memorable moments of gaming?
It's so broad.
It's broad, but it's a great question. Actually, before we answer that, I just want to go ahead and state, if you guys want to send us questions, please do so in the comments below, or you can send them to wolfycoms@gmail.com. Once more, that's wolfycoms@gmail.com. Or you can send it to one of our Twitters. We'll get back to you. Is that what they call it? Is that what the kids call it, the Twitters?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You make it sound like you're an old man.
I am old. But the thing is... But do you bleed? Not recently. Not lately. I'll get back to you on that one. I will, though. I know. Fuck. Can't get away from it. But yes, if you ask... You can ask us any type of question. From gaming, personal life, you don't want to know more about us, even fuck, marry, kills, you can do those too. I welcome all questions.
Wait, what?
Please, just ask away. We will answer them, we promise. Don't be shy. Alright, so the question was, I already asked what the question was, do you guys have an answer? Anyone want to pipe up first? Favorite games and memorable moments of gaming?
How about you go first?
You want me to go first?
Yeah.
Okay. Favorite
I
games.
Know your answer.
You sure do. Favorite games include Sonic CD, Brave Fencer Musashi. This is difficult because I got to narrow down like my top five. I don't want a list. Phantasy Star Online Episode 1-2.
Does that count as two games?
Finished online then. Smartass. Shoot, this is hard. There's so many good games. There's so many.
There's one I'm expecting you to say, and if you don't, I'm gonna be sad.
Really?
Go on.
Of course, Shining Force is on there.
Which one?
Can I just say the series?
If you say the series, then it includes the Resonance and all that.
No, they don't. The old, okay, one. Let me clarify. The old school Shining games.
Then pick just one.
I can't. Why? What rules are what rule
because
is that?
I am adding rules.
Okay.
He's adding stipulations.
Which one was better than all the other ones? Your little.
Yeah, if you're
going
to recommend someone to play the Shining game, what would
This is hard.
I can answer your own question for you. I'm going to say
do.
Two.
Two
love Shining Force 2.
Two is amazing, but
missing a key character.
We're just like Shining Force 3 because of one thing, but Shining Force 3 is, I'll say, probably the best one, definitely, because 1 and 2 are amazing. We're not counting Shining in the Darkness or Shining the Holy Ark, but those are also amazing. But Shining Force 3, it just has. Like varied, like what's the word I'm looking for? Missions, rather than just defeat all enemies on the map, defeat the boss of the map. It had the whole. There's missions where you have to rescue villagers. There's missions where you have to do certain things. It mixed it up a little bit, despite the bad voice acting on a certain all the characters.
Bad voice acting.
Now bear my Arctic blast. By the way, I know what this podcast ending theme is gonna be. You right. Wanted it. You wanted it.
Perfect.
You clever girl. You led right to it. Perfect. All right.
I got the first exit theme, and now I get the second.
God damn it! He's stealing these from us. He's stealing these. I'll say Shining Force 3. 2 is definitely good, though, and 1 is great for a starter, but 3 is the one I'd recommend. It's got 3 scenarios that all eventually link up.
We only got one of,
but there's ways to get this other 2, which I'll eventually do whenever I get back to them.
It's okay, I know how you feel.
Yeah,
I feel
you
like
know the other series that you know Camelot has made.
Yeah, Golden Sun.
Golden Sun.
Mm-hmm.
They left me with blue balls.
Yeah. Hey, now you know how the Shining guys feel. Eternally blue balled. And
someday they'll go back to it.
They will eventually, because Nintendo owns it, so why not? When they're done making Mario Tennis games, of course.
Yes, unfortunately.
Yeah, not great. And final, I will say... Shenmue 2.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm. And that also ties into the second part of the question, which was memorable moments of gaming. When I was... fucking... goddamn. So many years ago, when I was young, and I originally got my first Xbox... Oh, wait, I want to say Jet Set Radio Future was on that list too, but never mind. But when I got my original Xbox, it came with Jet Set Radio Future, Sega GT, and I got Shenmue 2 with it. I played Jet Set Radio Future, first time I ever played an open world, kind of open worldish game like that. But Shenmue 2, after I played Shenmue 1, it blew my fucking mind. Just everything you could do in that game. It felt like such a step up from the first game. A lot of people say the first game is better because of the whole hometown familiarity, but I think the second one, because it's a new, like, it's a new location in general, I thought that one was super fun to explore for the first time, meeting people and going into different buildings, and God, the music, I can go on, but yeah, Shenmue 2 is definitely up there with my favorite games. It's
Hey, Wolf.
It's a really good experience, but yeah, go on.
It also has Lucky Hit.
It has Lucky Hit.
Lucky Hit, you can't
Lucky
beat
Hit.
That.
Would you like to play?
Forklift driving.
It does, sort of the first one. Oh,
that
my
was the
God.
First one, but yeah.
Oh, man, just... Oh, just a step up. A step up from one. It's great. Shenmue 2 will always be, like, a mind-blowing experience for me. Graphics... story, music, environments, night and day, different things would happen during different times. It was so expansive. I love that game. That is the answer to that question. You either one of you want to take a shot at that question?
I guess I will start.
All right.
Let's see. What are my favorite games? I'll do my top five.
Dragon Quarter.
You.
Go on.
You be quiet. Even though my first one was going to be a Breath of Fire game.
That's why I said Dragon Quarter before you could.
Dick.
Oh, we knew it was coming.
You read my mind, but not the Dragon Quarter part. It was Breath of Fire 2. That game had an emotional impact in my life. Thank you very much, but not Dragon Quarter.
I thought you were going to go 3.
I mean, 3 was good, but like 2, its story was like really good. And it was really, really dark.
Mike, you hadn't played an RPG that had a storyline like that up until that point?
Pretty much. Then, like, each character had, like... besides one character... had, like, a connection with, like, story. Like, you actually could just play it, then you could actually, like... be in the shoes of the character and, like, actually understand, like, what the character's going through.
Yeah.
And I love that.
Like, yeah, I honestly was... I'm with Bert. I thought you were going to say 3, too, but now... I didn't realize that 2 had such an emotional story.
I mean, it was one of those, you know, generic stories that you're killing God.
I mean, yeah, but at the time, right? Like, it's overdone now, where it's like, oh, yeah, oh, sure, RPG where you go out and kill a god, but, like, back in the day,
that was actually, like,
new.
Impressive.
Yeah.
But it wasn't technically God. It was a demon posing as God. But you don't know that until, like, the very end. And then you pretty much stop that. But, okay. Anyways,
that's
after
one.
That... That's one. Two, Metal Gear Solid.
That's a good
that
one.
That game also had an impact, just mostly on the way it was, like, the storytelling elements were. Then the fact that you got to keep Otacon or Meryl alive. And it does, like, the whole fourth wall thing most of the time. But yeah, there's that. And number three, Street Fighter.
Which one?
The Street Fighter.
Hey, no, you gotta narrow it down because Fine. Bird did it to me.
You want me to narrow it down?
He likes the first one. He said Street Fighter.
Street Fighter 1?
Street Fighter. Like,
oh no.
No. Street Fighter 2.
Okay. Oh.
I know you're salty about
I know,
that, but...
I'm salty. I'm just gonna go ahead and say your reasons. Don't let me impact your decision. Because I won't.
This will relate with my memorable moments in gaming. But, it was just one of those first arcade games I've ever played, and I loved it. It made me feel like I was involved in something, and I just loved it.
I could see that.
That, and, let's see, that was three, right? Number four.
That was three.
Number four, Final Fantasy VII. Because that also solidified my RPG love. I mean, I played Breath of Fire 2 before that, but like when I played Final Fantasy 7, that was my first like 3D RPG, and I loved it. The same reason Bert probably likes Final Fantasy 7.
What's
right?
Up?
You like Final Fantasy 7, right?
7's good, yeah.
Yeah.
Bert, pay attention.
Sorry, yeah. I was playing with this tape.
Come on, I'm just snapping my fingers here, Bert.
I was listening.
Listen to his fucking game listing.
But you didn't say Dragon Quarter, so I was like, oh.
Uh-huh.
Of course you'd say that.
I'm going to give you so much shit for your list, Bert. Can't wait.
I don't even know if I have one, but all right.
All right, go on, Scoots. What's your fifth?
My fifth one? It's like a tie between Sonic the Hedgehog and Legend of Zelda. But I'm going to say Sonic because...
No, come on.
Yeah!
You thought I was going to say
Eat it, Bert!
Something?
Really?
Eat it, Bert!
What Sonic game is better than A Link to the Past?
Sonic 3 and Knuckles.
Really? Oh. You would say that game's a better game than A Link to the Past?
Hey, I have played that game so many times, and I go back to it. I think I went back to that.
I never saw you. I never saw you record a video on it.
I tried, remember? I used the shitty Roxio, if you remember correctly.
I remember.
Also, viewers, never get the Roxio. Maybe they've changed. Maybe they've changed now, but, like, it was really bad when I messed with it.
Man.
He's not saying Zelda's a bad game. He's just saying...
I was very surprised that he would say anything Sonic-related.
Really, Bert?
Yeah.
I said something Sonic-related.
Yeah. I know you would. Come on, now.
Yeah,
are you
well,
serious?
Guess what?
I didn't think you were that huge of a Sonic fan.
Are you kidding
it's,
me?
If you actually played the games when you were younger and had a fucking childhood...
Oh, I played one of them when I was younger.
You played Spinball, the worst one.
Uh-huh.
You
Number
suck.
One on my list.
Your opinion is awful. And it's...
Go on, Skates. go on and talk about your Sonic 3. It's fine.
Popping blood vessels over
game.
Here. It's a good game.
That game had everything I liked in it. Including the power-ups. Freaking Bubble Shield.
It's a game of multiple replayability.
I have replayed that game so many times. I've always been positive about it. I've done all the characters, done all the emeralds, even did the super emeralds.
And he hates special stages. Half pipes.
Depend. Yeah, half-pipe. I was going to say, if it's half pipes, I'm just kind of like... Especially Sonic Rush, because I was scared to destroy the screen.
I remember that. I had to do that one for you.
Like, the hardest one, I was like, hey, Wolf, you should do this for me, because I'm scared I'm just going to scratch the crap out of my screen. Because this was at the time where, like, I didn't know my own strength. So, like, I remember when I first got my my DS, right?
Mm-hmm,
I touched the screen, one. And I scratched the crap out of the screen.
I remember
and I was like, oh, shit.
And at that time... You had the fat DS, so it fit in my fat, giant hands, so you didn't have to worry about me breaking it.
I know, right?
It was the one time you could lend me your thing without worrying about me breaking it.
And this was at the time you didn't exactly have...
I didn't have shit, dude.
Yeah. No, you had the one DS.
I had the calculator.
And you wrote DS
on it. People all around the school came from far and wide to play my DS. It
that
had
was
one
the
game.
Best DS.
It was.
It's called Putting Upside Down Boobless.
Like, I remember at that point in high school, Scoots, you were the only one with a DS. Everybody gave you shit for that.
I know, everyone. And I got rid of it. Then I got a PSP, and then I started missing my DS, and I got another DS.
Everybody in our school had a PSP. Everyone had a PSP. You had the DS, but you eventually got a PSP. I was the only freaker there playing on a Game Boy Advance. Original, not even an SP. An original Game Boy Advance. I was so freaking poor. You had to feed me at lunch. We can go over this another time, but this has nothing to do with the question.
You had that sock full of pennies, though.
You know where I got that sock full of pennies to pay for that PSP?
Where'd you get it?
Just knock someone out with that thing.
I don't think I didn't try.
So, okay. It's just okay. A different turn.
You do a bunch of, like, wishing fountains?
Don't ask how I got the pennies. I just had them. Like, brief story for the listeners. Back in the day when we were all in high school, the guy I refer to as Jesus, because he looked like Jesus, had a PSP he was selling. He was selling for like 70 or 80 bucks. And I was like, hey, let me get in on some of that action. So I, being the cool guy I was with no physical money, went and found a method of getting $80 worth of pennies, nickels, dimes, and quarters, mostly pennies, into a bag and giving it to Jesus
bag?
In exchange for a PSP.
I think that's being generous.
It was a Crown Royal bag.
Oh, I didn't realize that. I thought it was a sock.
No. Oh, no. Did he tell you it was a sock?
That's what I remembered it as.
No, it wasn't a sock. Maybe it was. I thought it was a Crown Royal bag.
I mean,
bag.
If it was a Crown Royal bag, that's pretty fancy.
It was super fancy. Don't ask how I got it, though.
I'd be all right with that.
Okay.
Pretty sure it was a long sock.
I do recall it being a sock, though, actually. I thought it was a Crown Royal. I might be remembering it differently, but yeah, he got his money, and he just looked at
do
me.
Do you know the funny thing is? You know what he did to your pennies?
Please tell me.
He liquefied your pennies, and he made a freaking copper sword out of it.
Oh, he didn't even go to the coin star,
yeah,
which existed back then?
I didn't understand that myself. I'm like, why would you do that?
This was like, just for reference, this was like, hang on, like eight,
I think
no,
this
eight,
was before
10 years ago?
Yeah, I think this was before Coinstars.
Yeah. It'd be a little over 10 years now.
Yeah, yeah, it was a while ago, but yeah, I still have his PSP. He probably still has that copper sword.
Do you still have that thing?
I still have it. Mm-hmm.
Doesn't have a battery, but I still have it.
He took really good care of it. There was hardly anything wrong with it. I don't think he used it.
That sounds about right.
Yeah.
Whenever he got it, was the PSP that old?
Yeah, it came out when we were all in high school.
Like, I remember when he got it for Untold Legends.
Oh yeah,
oh,
he
God.
Gave me that game with it. I remember that game.
That was a decent launch title, wasn't it?
It was fun to play with people.
But like, I remember they kept going with them, and they just got worse and worse, if I recall.
Yeah.
Only reason I wanted a PSP, and Scoots knows why, it was because of Street Fighter Alpha 3 on the PSP. Yeah, you showed me it on PSP, and I was like, I didn't know fighting games could be on the handheld. I must have one.
You denied that so hard.
I couldn't, dude.
You also denied PCs.
Shut up, Bert. Up until that point, I'd only played fighting games on a Game Boy with two buttons. Like Battle Arena Toshiden, sick game, but I was like, passable, but there's so much more that could happen. And then fucking just, oh my god, Street Fighter Alpha 3 in full, like, up to that point, HD on a PSP, just count me in, dude. I could play my fighting games on the go. It was something so, it blew my mind. I had to have a PSP. Then Jesus sold me his. It all worked out.
Well,
we went completely off topic from the question. Let me go back
to the question. Jeez.
Sorry.
And now my memorable moments of gaming is when I actually went and actually was exposed to my very first arcade. this was like an actual arcade, not like one that you see like in a bowling alley. It's like only like two or three little arcade cabinets.
Yeah, the ones the babies are fucking shit on and put peanut butter in the coin slots.
I don't know, adults probably do that too.
You know what I used to do at the bowling alley with those types of arcade machines?
What's that?
Used to eat chicken strips with barbecue sauce on top of that thing while playing Soul Calibur or Soul Edge.
Okay, you scared me at first. I thought you said you were going to eat the peanut butter out of the coin slot.
Whoa,
Oh, that's, okay, continue your story, please.
I remember, like, it was me and a whole bunch of other people would just do that, and I remember people would get barbecue sauce all over the arcade. Yeah, it was terrible.
It's awful.
But we were young and dumb.
Yeah. And full of money. In socks.
Quarters. And always had to beg, like, our parents to give us quarters. You got any quarters? What's quarters to play arcade? Please, I want some quarters. But anyways, this arcade I went to was in the Philippines. And it was a Sega arcade. Do you see where I'm going with this?
No, just go on. Go on.
It was a big giant Sega arcade, and I was exposed to like a lot of games. Like House of the Dead. Maybe I should stop here.
Oh, no, just no, just a few more. A few more names. Just drop a few more names, please.
Virtua Cop.
Oh, God.
Actually, a lot of Virtua Cop games. Virtua Fighter. That's actually where I played all three at once.
That is sick.
And, it was that, and, there was a few others. That's where I was also exposed to Street Fighter 2. That was Street Fighter 3. It was when I was exposed over there. But, I mean, the Street Fighter 2 there, but I was exposed to the Turbo edition over there, and then I was all happy about it. But the whole thing about Street Fighter 2, that actually changed my whole love of, like, arcades, because, like, when I was in arcades, I only played, like, puzzle games and occasionally, you know, those SNK arcade machines?
Yeah.
Like, with Metal Slug and stuff? Yeah. I'd play that, and I also love Metal Slug. But, yeah, it was that. If I didn't have arcades, this would have not... Let's say I'd be a different person.
Arcades changed your life for the better.
Yeah, maybe you'd like Link to the Past more.
Oh, hey, bro,
stop being a bitter person and accept that you like Sonic.
Bert.
Oh, what's up?
I love Link to the Past. You know what? I lost track of how many times I bought that game now. I just bought it for the 3DS. New 3DS.
You know what? Fine. For the viewers at home and for the listeners who are probably freaking out that he said Sonic over Link to the Past, he actually meant Link to the Past first. That was the game. Sonic 3 and Knuckles are after. Gotta make babies like Bert happy.
This is why I can't do a top 5. I can't do a top 5 with
you. Didn't say in any particular order,
Bert. This is why you never see a top 5 in my
Sonic
channel.
Not on the list.
We all know you have a thing for fucking blue mascot characters. Leave them alone.
You know what else I'm going to say next, Bert?
What's that?
Here. Do you want me to say Mega Man? Does this please you? Because I was going to say Mega Man Legends somewhere. Because I love that game, too.
Do you like the first one or the second one more?
Second one. It's an expansive adventure.
Which one did you kick the can with?
One.
Both of them.
One.
Oh. Okay.
No.
The second one, you can kick a rubber ducky.
They really stepped their A game up.
And you can kick rabbits. We'll talk about kicking the rabbits.
I prefer to bowl the rabbits.
Speaking of bowling rabbits, Bert, why don't you tell us your top five games and your memorable experience?
Well, we already mentioned one of them.
Uh-huh.
So, yeah, Sonic Spinball.
Bert, you are this close. <What's up? laughs> You are this close to rustling my jimmies tonight.
On a more legit serious note, yeah, we got Quest 64. That game's awesome.
No, go roll with it. No, I'm not saying anything.
And then we got Shining Blade.
Okay. My Jimmy's a Russell. He's done it. That's it.
Damn it, Bert.
What? That's it. That's it.
I'm you out. Don't like those games?
I'm out. I quit this fucking podcast. Bert?
What?
For fuck's sakes. What's your game?
We're
Bert. Over time.
Where are we at?
We're 2 hours and 6 minutes in.
Ah, that's normal.
We're over. We are over the limit. We gotta wrap this up. Wrap it up, Bert. Wrap it up.
I don't really know.
What? Just say like a couple
you
games
don't have
you
a
like.
Favorite game? What?
There's so many, dude. I don't
just
know.
Say,
so many.
Just say
I can narrow
some.
It down. You give me shit.
You give me shit.
That's what I do.
We've only named five. And we could go on forever. Name one. You
yeah,
big.
Well.
You big. Babu.
I like video games.
First right. one. There you go.
All right.
There you go.
I'll do it for him.
All right. I want to hear this list.
Oh, you actually let me do it.
Yeah, I'd love to hear this.
All right. Number one. Or should I say number five?
Hey, you said they're in no particular order.
That's true.
We just count them off, so
Diablo you can... 2.
Diablo 2 is a good game. I don't know if I put it in my top five, but
nope.
Yeah.
Top five. All
right, go on.
You don't get to say anything, Bert. You didn't say anything.
Number two.
This is his list. Valkyra, your shit.
Valkyra Chronicles.
That's a great game. That'd probably be on the list.
Number three. Way of the Samurai.
Probably wouldn't be on the list, but I do like those games.
One.
Dead Rising.
No.
Oh jeez, number four. Tactics Ogre.
You're very good. Damn. I'm surprised you pulled that one out.
Are you trying to say that I don't know your favorite games?
I didn't know you would come up with that one though. That's pretty obscure.
Scoots knows a lot about RPGs, dude. He's right up there with you in RPG knowledge.
That's a pretty good pull. I like that.
You've impressed him. Go on, Scoots. Give him the coup de grace.
Number five. Now let me go to the top of my mind here of what you get, what you like here. You know what? Fuck it. It's like Spinball.
Well, it was bound to happen eventually.
Even Scoots agrees.
You know what? You still haven't told us what your memorable moment of gaming was.
I already told you mine.
No, I'm talking about Bert.
Well, a lot of my favorite games are ones that... like, have different paths in them. Because when I was little, I had a friend that we'd just always play RPGs with. Mm-hmm. And when you could have, like, different paths that you can go on, it meant we could see two sides while playing the same game. So stuff like Tactics Ogre, which has like three completely different routes, were awesome. Because we could play it and have completely different experiences. Stuff like Front Mission 3, where, again, one decision leads to two completely different stories.
That was the game.
And then there's games like Resident Evil, where you can play as two different characters. But I wouldn't really add that to like a favorite game, but...
This is why Resident Evil 2 will always be the best.
And one of my favorite games of all time is Brigandine. It is like a strategy game on the PS1 where you take over castles. I guess another one if I want to keep going would be Neverwinter Nights 2, because Mask of the Betrayer is awesome.
I have that game.
You have that game?
I got Neverwinter Nights, my bad.
Yeah, like they don't even sell it on Steam anymore.
I got it from Jesus.
It's so good. Like, if anyone wants to play Neverwinter Nights 2, that game was broken as hell at launch. But Mask of the Betrayer is amazing. There's some list.
I'm sorry, I was laughing to myself because I was actually thinking of just fucking fading in the music as you were saying your list to end the podcast.
Do it. I'm good with that.
No, because we have to officially end it because that is
Bert
the end of our podcast.
No, then I could have...
I know the beat's gonna be the next podcast, I'm gonna tell you to put the Doge song.
I know, I'm ready for it.
Next podcast, so, I'll somehow slip one in there. Fine.
No, I already ended it right now. The ending's gonna be the dog song from Silent Hill.
No, it's not over yet. Hang on. We're getting ahead of ourselves. We still got one more thing to say before this is over. Final closing, which is, what are our upcoming plans for this next week, next few weeks? Because this is actually gonna be a bi-weekly podcast. Just for mostly my sake, since I'm the host, I don't want to fucking overload myself.
You know, maybe you would have only hour-long episodes if you did every week instead of.
You know, Bert, I consider it.
It's already over 2 hours.
But I'm doing it despite you, so fuck. So what is your guys' weeks coming up?
Dark Souls 3.
Good answer.
Dark Souls 3.
I will be continuing Dark Souls 3, New Game Plus. I will be watching you play it, Justin.
Yep.
And I will be watching.
Don't use our real names.
And I will be watching.
I already used your name.
I will be watching just the tutorials. So I'll just leave it at that.
Okay. And I guess my week will be Dark Souls 3, of course.
And who the hell's gonna call you Wolf? That's so dumb.
You're dumb.
You did.
I know, and it sounds dumb. So
you're
stop
stupid,
it.
Bert. I will. I'm telling you my week. Shut up.
I don't care about your week.
Dark Souls 3 is my week, and okay. I'm also going to try to finish up Fire Emblem's Conquest. Yeah, that's it. And I'm also getting paid. Can't wait for the paycheck. Too. Paycheck. All for the dollar. I'm going to pay off my fucking student loans.
That sounds like. That sounds very familiar to what I'm doing.
Sounds
shit.
Like the responsible, smart thing to do. Huh?
I'm gonna buy a BenQ monitor.
Yeah.
You just got one.
He wants a second one. If you listened to the first part of our first podcast, you would have known that, jackass.
You.
Mm-hmm.
You
fish
Sonic
memory.
Lovers.
Oh. Hey. Jimmy's are rustling again.
He didn't say what his true favorite one was. No, it's not CD.
Mine? Talking about Sonic Labyrinth?
Oh, Black fuck
Knight.
Off. No.
Black
no.
Knight.
No. This is awful. This thing is ending right now. This is it. My name is Wolfie. Those two idiots over there are dumb. This podcast is over. We're never doing this again. Fade in the music.